Hello and welcome to Sketch Together. My name is Pablo Stanley, and this is part of a series on Photoshop tricks for UI designers that use Sketch or Figma or Adobe XD as their main design tool, but still need to use Photoshop for some quick image fixes. On this video, we're going to learn how to use the spot healing tool to fix some blemishes in a photo. This could be applied to blemishes in a skin or probably in a wall, in some elements that you don't want to be there. Pretty powerful and simple tool. Okay, so sometimes you need to remove some blemishes on the skin. And to do that, you can use the spot healing tool. And before we start, only use this tool on a portrait or on a face if your client is okay with that. If they want to do that and they are okay with you removing some of the blemishes, then do that. If not, just use the natural skin, how it looks. So here I have a portrait and she asked me, can we remove some of this stuff? And to remove that, it's really easy. I'm just going to go here on my spot healing tool that you can find on your toolbar, spot healing tool, just like that. And then I'm going to create a new layer. Once I create the new layer, here on the options, I want this, the type, to be content aware. And then also to sample all the layers. That way it will have all the healing in a separate layer without actually changing my original photo. So now that I have this, I can just start painting just like that. I can adjust the size of my brush if I wanted to, a little bit bigger. And I can just start painting like that. Probably this. There you go. Let's say that we want to remove that. Let's say that she wants to remove this. I wouldn't remove it, but let's say that she wants to. Let's say that she wants to remove all of that. You just paint over it and it does it. So let's see a before and after. You can see how it removes that. It just like takes samples from around where you're painting, and then it's creating a new spot. So for example, let's say that we want to remove this little dot here. I just do here, and all it did is just like take samples from around, and then it created a new dot. So there you go. How cool is that? The spot healing tool not only works for skin, but it also works for any other type of texture like wood. Let's see at this example. Here I have a website where I have a photo in the background. As you can see, I took this photo, but I forgot to clean up the table. So now I need to clean up all this stuff, right? And probably some stuff here. So I need to go back to Photoshop. So I'm going to open the photo. Open, and here I have it. It's Calavera. This is your original photo that I took. And as you can see here, I zoom in and I have that candy here, and I have a nut here and some other stuff here. So let's clean that up. So I'm going to zoom in, and first thing, I'm going to add a new layer, and then I'm going to select the spot healing tool. And then over here, I already have it as sample all layers, and I have the type as content aware. And I'm going to make, you want to make the size, adjust the size of your brush just by right clicking and then adjust the size of it. Going to make it a little bit bigger because this is a big thing that I need to fix here. And since the background is wood texture and I have content aware as a type of healing, what it will do is just like grab pieces of the texture from around and then just fill it up where I paint. So I'm just going to start painting here around there. I want to all of this. And there you go. Now the pill is gone. If you want to fix it a little bit more. There you go. Now let's do the same here. Just going to paint all of this stuff around there. And boom, it's gone. If you want to, probably you can still see the spot. So sometimes it's good to just like do finishing touches. Let's do the same over here. There you go. It's gone. Let's zoom out. It looks like there are some other pieces that I could fix. Although that's kind of like the wear and tear. Oh, there you go. Something here. There you go. Let's paint this. That looks good. Let's zoom out. That looks good. I'm going to save this as Calavera fixed as a PSD. I'm going to close Photoshop. And over here, I'm going to go back to Sketch. And here on Sketch, I'm going to replace the image fill here. Instead of the one that I had, I'm going to select the PSD that I just fixed. And let's see how it looks. And there you go. Now it's gone. So let's Command-Z. That's how it was before. And now Command-Shift-Z. And there you go. Now it's fixed and I can continue working on my design. And that's it. Hopefully you're finding these tutorials useful. Leave a comment. And if you have a suggestion for another video on Photoshop for you as a UI designer that you probably need to do stuff like this, leave it in the comments and I'll do my best on creating a tutorial on it. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.